Problem statement: write a Python program to store first year percentage of students in array. Okay, and then write a function for sorting array of floating point numbers in ascending order. Okay, using number one selection sort and number two using bubble sort, and display top five scores. Okay, so this is the problem statement. Now for this we have already discussed what is bubble sort and what is selection sort. Okay, so accordingly this selection sort logic is written here and bubble sort logic is written here. Okay, so first of all I will just quickly go through this bubble sort method. Bubble sort is a sorting algorithm. It is a comparison based sorting algorithm in which each pair of adjacent elements are compared and the elements are swapped if they are not in ascending order. Okay, this is a simple sorting technique in which the adjacent elements are compared with each other, and if they are not in particular order, that is ascending order, then they will be swapped. Right, for example, see here, this is our original input, right? 5, 1, 4, 2, and 8. These are the five elements and we need to apply a bubble sort on these five numbers in order to sort these numbers. Okay, right now you can observe that these numbers are not in sorted order. 5, 1, 4, 2, 8, they are randomly arranged. Okay, so what bubble sort tells: starting from the first element, that is this 5, and comparing 5 with 1. Okay, these are the two adjacent elements, so these two elements will be compared with each other. Okay, if they are not in particular ascending order, then both elements will be swapped. Right, so 5 is greater than 1, right? So these are not in ascending order, so we need to swap them. We need to swap their orders, right? So 1 will come here and 5 will go here, right? So 5 1 5 1 we have arranged like 1 5. Okay, so now the first two elements are in sorted order. Next we will concentrate on these two elements, 5 and its adjacent element, 5 and 4. Right, since 5 is greater than 4, they are also not in ascending order, so what we'll do, we will swap these two numbers. Right, 4 will come here, 5 will go here, as shown here. Right, next these two elements will be compared, 5 and 2. Since 5 is greater than 2, they are not in ascending order, so again we will swap these two. So 2 will come here, 5 will go here, as shown here. Okay, next the last two elements will be compared, 5 and 8. Now as 5 is less than 8, here we don't need to swap, right? They are, because they are already in ascending order, right? So no swap will be required. So this is first pass. ठीक है, जेव्हा आपण लास्ट एलिमेंट पर्यंत जातो तेव्हा एक पास आपला कंप्लीट होतो, बरोबर? नाउ द सेकंड पास स्टार्ट्स. It is not always possible that the elements will be sorted in first pass itself. It will require several passes. Right. Now in first pass, we have one element which is least element among all elements. Right. आता second pass मध्ये आपण काय करतोय, परत starting चे दोन elements आपण compare करतोय. Right. 1 is compared with 4. as 1 is less than 4, no swapping is required. Right. Next, compare 4 and 2. Now 4 is greater than 2, that's why swapping is required. So 2 will come here, 4 will go here, as shown here. Right. Next, again next two elements will be compared. These two elements are already in sorted order, so no swap is required. And lastly, compare these two. These are also arranged in proper order. Right. So no swap is required. Now, the elements are like 1, 2, 4, 5, 8. Now, the array is already sorted, but our algorithm does not know if it is completed or not. Right. जरी आपल्याला इथे दिसते आहे की हे एलिमेंट्स आता सॉर्ट झालेले आहेत पण आपल्या अल्गोरिथमला अजून हे माहिती नाही आहे ऑल द एलिमेंट्स आर सॉर्टेड ऑर नॉट सो फॉर दॅट वी नीड वन मोर पास राईट अल्गोरिथम नीड्स वन होल पास विदाउट एनी स्वॅप टू एन्श्युअर दॅट इट इज सॉर्टेड मग एक थर्ड पास आपल्याला परत लागणार आहे परत थर्ड पासमध्ये आपण काय करणार आहे ॲडजसंट एलिमेंट आपण कम्पेअर करणार आहे वन अँड टू नो स्वॅप इज रिक्वायर्ड 2 and 4, no swap is required. 4 and 5, no swap is required. 5 and 8, no swap is required. Right. So after the end of third pass, now all the elements are ensured that they are in sorted order. Okay. So this is about the bubble sort technique. Now again come back to the program. This is our main function. Okay. In the main function, we have declared one empty array. Right. And the name of empty array is A. Now, we are using here switch statement. One for accepting the marks and displaying the marks from the user. Number two is selection sort in ascending order. Then bubble sort in descending order. Okay. Here we are applying selection sort to sort the elements in ascending order and we are using bubble sort to sort the element in descending order. Okay. And also we have to show the top 5 scores. Okay. So these are the options available in our program, right? So we will take the input from the user, enter your choice. If the user enters 4, so 4 is exit. So we will just quit from our program. Okay, otherwise, else if choice equal to 1, if the user enters 1. So 1 is what we have to accept and display the first year marks. Okay, so for that, first of all, we need to call this function accept array. Okay, and after accepting the array, we will display that array. So two methods are called here, accept array and display array. So first method is this one, accept array, and we are passing this empty array with this function. Okay, so from here we will go to the definition of this accept array method. Right, it is accepting the empty array passed from the calling function. Right, now here we will ask the user how many students are there. Okay, for how many students you want to enter the marks. So this is the syntax for inputting the elements from the user. We already discussed, right? So suppose user have entered here 7. Okay, so I have entered 7. So now 7 students marks we need to enter from the keyboard, right? So for that we need for loop, right? As we are dealing with more than one student, this loop should be executed for as many students are there, right? So for I in range n, So from 0 to 7, right? N is what here? 7. So 7 times we have to execute this loop, right? Now see this statement. Input, enter the first year percentage of student I plus 1. Initially I is what? 0, right? Because this loop is executing for 0 to 7, right? So value of I is 0. So the message will be like this: enter the first year percentage of student I plus 1, that is 0 plus 1, that is 1, right? So student 1, his marks will be entered from the keyboard, right? And that marks we are going to store in X, right? So whatever marks user have entered, that should be appended in our empty array, right? So first mark of the student will be appended in this A, right? Similarly, now I is incremented by 1. So enter the marks of enter the first year percentage of student 2. So again, marks for the second student will be entered, that is appended in the array, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th. Like this, the marks of 7 students will be appended in our array A, right? Next function that we are calling is display function, right? Now we have accepted the marks, now we have to display those marks. So we are calling this display array function, right? Here also we are starting from I in range 7, that is 0 to 7 we are considering, and we are just displaying those marks: A of 0, next time A of 1, next time A of 2, A of 3, A of 4, A of 5, A of 6. So 7 marks now will be displayed. Okay. Now here, what is this N? N contains the length of our array. Okay. Now in our array, we have entered 7 students' marks. So length of array will be 7, right? But we need to check whether there are elements in our array or not, right? For this purpose, we are using this statement: if n equal to equal to 0, means ya array madhe jar marks as nahi hai tar yachi length kiti yenar hai, n chi 0 yenar hai, barobar hai? So if n equal to equal to 0, then no records in the database. Only apan records as aplya database madhe store kelele nahi. But if n is greater than 1, in that case we are coming in else part, and else part madhe apan ek loop ghetlela hai 0 to 7, and just we are printing this A of I. So this is about display function. Ye apan 7 student che marks enter karun ghetle ani 6 marks ite display kelele ahet, theek hai? So up to this it is over. Now second is what? Selection sort in ascending order, right? So if user have entered 2, then we will print this message: marks before sorting. म्हणजे ॲज इट इज, जसे युजरने एंटर केलेले आहेत मार्क्स, तसे तेच मार्क्स आपल्याला सगळ्यात पहिले शो करायचे आहेत, राईट? सो मार्क्स बिफोर सॉर्टिंग असा मेसेज स्क्रीनवर दिसेल, आणि त्याच्यानंतर आपल्याला काय डिस्प्ले करायचे आहेत, जसे युजरने मार्क्स एंटर केलेले आहेत तसे. म्हणजे सिम्पली अगेन वी आर कॉलिंग हिअर द डिस्प्ले अरे फंक्शन, राईट? हेच फंक्शन आपण परत कॉल करणार आहे. सो द ओरिजिनल मार्क्स विल बी डिस्प्लेड टू द यूजर. ओके. Next we are calling the selection sort method. Okay, selection sort method is written here. ठीक आहे. आता नाउ यू हॅव टू रिकॉल द सिलेक्शन सॉर्ट टेक्निक. त्याच्यासाठी लेट मी शेअर स्क्रीन विथ यू. ओके, सो दिस इज द सिलेक्शन सॉर्ट मेथड वी हॅव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, राईट. इन दिस मेथड टू सॉर्ट द डेटा इन असेंडिंग ऑर्डर, the zeroth element is compared with all other elements. Zeroth element is 25, is compared with all the remaining elements. Okay, if the zeroth element is found to be greater than the compared element, then they are interchanged. If this zeroth element, that is 25, is greater than this 17, in that case what we have to do, we have to swap these two numbers, right, like this. So 25 is greater than 17, so we need to swap them. So 17 will come here and 25 will go here. Okay, next time again this zeroth element is compared with 31. Now it is not compared with 25 because it is already done, right. So 17 is compared with 31. Now 17 is lesser than 31, so no swap is required, no interchange is required, right. Next, 17 is compared with 13. Now as 17 is greater than 13, so we need to interchange, right. So 13 will come here and 17 will go here. See, here we are comparing 17 with 13. 17 is greater than this 13, so we need to swap the order, right. So 13 will come here, 17 will go here. Next, again zeroth element is compared with this last element. So again 13 is greater than 2, so we need to swap their order. So 2 will come here, 13 will go here, right. So after the first pass we will get one element which is the smallest element in all the elements, right. Now this 2 is already sorted, 2 is already sorted. So now we need to focus on these four elements, 25, 31, 17 and 13. So see here, 25, 31, 17 and 13. So again zeroth element is compared with 0 plus 1 element, right. 25 is smaller than 31, so no interchange is required. Now again 25 is compared with 17, now here swapping is required. So 17 will come here and this 25 will go here, right. Now 17 is compared with 13, again 17 is greater than 13, so we will swap. Okay, now after the second pass we will be having two elements sorted, 2 and 13. Now only three elements are remaining, so 31, 25, 17. Again this zeroth element is compared with 0 plus 1 and so on, right. Like this the elements will be compared, one element is compared with all other remaining elements, right. And finally we will get such type of sorting. Okay, 2, 13, 17, 25 and 31. Now this is the technique for selection sort. Now how we can implement it in program, let us see. See, now again we need to find out the length of our array, right. So length of array is what, 7, right. So n is equals to 7. Now we have to take one for loop for position in range n minus 1. So starting from 0 to n minus 1 means 6. So 0 to 6 it will be executed, right. So initially our position will be 0, right? Starting from 0 to 6, n minus 1 means 6. So we will iterate from 0 to 6. Next, one variable is declared here, minimum index. In this index, we are going to store the index of the smallest element. Okay, whichever position is there, that position is stored in minimum index. Ja element, jo element sagat chota hai, the list madhe. Theek hai, tachi position apan minimum index madhe store karnar. Theek hai, ithe parat ek index ghetlela hai apan, ata दोन लूप्स आपल्याला घ्यायचे आहेत, बरोबर आहे? कारण की पहिला एलिमेंट हा रिमेनिंग सगळ्या एलिमेंट सोबत आपल्याला कंपेअर करायचा आहे, राईट? फर्स्ट एलिमेंट दॅट इज झिरोथ एलिमेंट इज कंपेअर्ड विथ ऑल अदर एलिमेंट्स इन अवर ॲरे, राईट? सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम पोझिशन झिरो अँड वी आर कंपेअरिंग दिस झिरोथ एलिमेंट इन विथ ऑल अदर रिमेनिंग एलिमेंट्स. So definitely we are going to require two for loops. This is number one and this is number two, right? So position is zero and position plus one. So zeroth element is compared with first element, right? Zeroth element is compared with first element. So if zeroth element is smaller than the first element, in that case we don't need swapping, right? So just we are storing zeroth element in the minimum index, right? Next time zeroth element will be compared with second element. If zeroth element is greater than the second element, in that case we are going to swap. Theek hai na? Tyanantar zeroth element is compared with third element. Zeroth element is compared with fourth element, fifth element and sixth element likewise, right? आणि सगळ्यात शेवटी आपल्याला काय मिळणार आहे, इथे एक मिनिमम इंडेक्स आपल्याला मिळणार आहे विच इज गोइंग टू होल्ड द स्मॉलेस्ट व्हॅल्यू इन अवर ऑल द सेवन व्हॅल्यूज, राईट? नेक्स्ट टाइम आता एक हा लूप कंप्लीट झाल्यानंतर आपण या लूपमध्ये जाणार आहे. आता पोझिशन आपली एकनी इन्क्रिमेंट होणार आहे, बरोबर आहे? अर्लिअर इनिशियली वी हॅड स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम पोझिशन झिरो, वी हॅड कम्पेअर्ड झिरोथ एलिमेंट विथ ऑल अदर एलिमेंट्स, राईट? सो नाव अगेन वी आर कमिंग हिअर, नाव पोझिशन विल बी इन्क्रिमेंटेड, नाव वी आर फोकसिंग ऑन फर्स्ट एलिमेंट, राईट? झिरोथ एलिमेंट इज ऑलरेडी सॉर्टेड नाव, नाव फर्स्ट एलिमेंट. अगेन वी आर रिपीटिंग द सेम स्टेप्स. फर्स्ट एलिमेंट इज कम्पेअर्ड विथ सेकंड एलिमेंट, first is compared with third element, first is compared with fourth element, first is compared with fifth and sixth, seventh, likewise. Okay, next time again position is incremented, so now two elements will be sorted. So we will start from the third element with fourth element, third element with fifth element and so on. Theek hai, asha prakare ite hai execute honar hai, theek hai? And at last maybe after fifth or sixth pass we will get all the elements sorted. ठीक है, हे तुम्ही हे करून बघा. तुम्ही सात एलिमेंट्स घ्या, एका ॲरे मध्ये ते स्टोअर करा, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम झिरो, झिरो वन टू थ्री असे ॲरेचे इंडेक्सेस द्या, एलिमेंट्स तिथे स्टोअर करा आणि त्यानंतर हा जो अल्गोरिथम आहे हा तुम्ही तिथे ॲक्च्युअली एक्झिक्यूट करून घ्या. दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट द सिलेक्शन सॉर्ट. ठीक आहे, नेक्स्ट नाव अप टू दिस इट इज ओवर. थर्ड इज बबल सॉर्ट इन डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. ओके, सो बबल सॉर्ट यू हॅव टू अप्लाय बट इन डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. ओके, बिकॉज वी हॅव टू फाइंड आउट द टॉप फाईव्ह मार्क्स ऑफ द स्टुडंट्स. ओके, म्हणून आपण बबल सॉर्टला आपण असेंडिंग न घेता आपण डिसेंडिंगमध्ये कन्सिडर करतो आहे. ठीक है। सो नंबर थ्री, अगेन वी आर शोइंग दिस मैसेज मार्क्स बिफोर सॉर्टिंग। ओके, सो ओरिजिनल मार्क्स विल बी डिस्प्लेड एंड देन वी आर कॉलिंग दिस बबल सॉर्ट मेथड। ओके, बबल सॉर्ट मध्ये काय होते मी आताच तुम्हाला सांगितलेलं आहे, परत लेट अस रिव्हिजिट दिस। ओके, सो दिस इज our original array and this we need to sort. Okay, so first element is compared with second element, second element is compared with third element, third element is compared with fourth element, fourth element is compared with fifth element, right? So all the adjacent elements will be compared with each other. Okay, but in selection sort what we did, we focused on this zeroth element, right? And this zeroth element we compared with first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, right? Then first element is compared with second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Then third element is compared with fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh, right? Like this we did in case of selection sort, but this is bubble sort. Now in bubble sort, two adjacent elements will be compared with each other, right? Starting from zeroth element, zeroth element is compared with first element, then first element is compared with second element, and second is compared with third, third is compared with fourth, fourth is compared with fifth, and so on. Theek hai, in second pass now again zeroth element with first, first with second, second with third, third with fourth, and so on. Theek hai, ani generally it is it gets the elements get sorted in the second or third pass, right? But we need additional one pass in order to ensure that all the elements are sorted, right? So this is bubble sort. Now this technique we are applying, but we are applying this in reverse direction. Okay, that is in descending order, right? So this is the method, simple method ahe. Again we need to find out the length of our array. So we have a total 7 elements, so n is 7 here, right? Ta aplyala ithe sudha don loops gyav lagnar ahet for pass in range 1 to n, that is 1 to 7. 1 to 7 elements he apan ithe consider karnar ahe. Tyanantar for I in range n minus pass, ata n minus pass mhanje kay ahe, tar pass mhanje kiti ahe, pass chi range kay ahe, 1 to n, barobar ahe, mhanje starting from 1, right? So pass here is equal to 1, right? Now see here, for I in range n minus pass, आता n किती आहे आपला, 7 आहे, we have 7 elements, right? 7 minus pass, pass is what, 1, so 7 minus 1, that is 6, right? So I in range 0 to 6, so here I is equals to 0, that is starting position, right? So I is starting from 0, and this is starting from 1, right? Now if a of I is what, 0, right? So a of 0, if it is less than a of I plus 1, means a of 1, all right? So if the first element is less than the second element, in short, if the first element is less than second element, in that case what we have to do, as we are arranging the elements in descending order, aplyala motha element jo ahe to pehle ghyava lagnar ahe, barobar ahe? So bigger element is what, a of I plus 1, theek hai na? ते तुम्ही कन्सिडर करा की असे आपले काही एलिमेंट्स आहेत, लेट अस से 14 अँड लेट अस से हियर 20, हे दोन एलिमेंट्स आहेत सपोज, ठीक आहे. सो दिस इज ए ऑफ आय अँड दिस इज ए ऑफ आय प्लस 1, राईट. नाऊ द स्टेटमेंट इज लाईक इफ ए ऑफ आय इज लेस दॅन ए ऑफ आय प्लस 1, मीन्स इफ 14 इज लेस दॅन 20, इन दॅट केस आपल्याला काय करावं लागेल, आपल्याला या दोघांना स्वॅप करावं लागेल. तो स्वॅपिंगसाठी इथे आपण हे लॉजिक लिहिलेलं आहे, एक टेम्पररी व्हेरिएबल घेतला आणि स्वॅपिंग केला आपण, बरोबर आहे. म्हणजेच आफ्टर स्वॅपिंग काय होईल, आफ्टर स्वॅपिंग दिस विल बिकम 20 अँड 14, राईट. म्हणजे बिगर एलिमेंट फर्स्ट देन स्मॉलर एलिमेंट, ठीक आहे ना. असंच हे आता मी दोन एलिमेंटसाठी केलं, असंच तुम्हाला हे सात एलिमेंटसाठी करावं लागेल, बरोबर आहे. अँड आफ्टर 7 एलिमेंट्स द एलिमेंट्स विल बी लाईक दिस वन, जसे 13, देन लेट अस से 10, देन 8, देन 5, देन 3, देन 2 अँड सो ऑन, राईट. तो ॲट द एंड ऑफ दिस बबल सॉर्ट मेथड वी विल गेट समथिंग आउटपुट लाईक दिस, बरोबर आहे. सो आता आपण ऑलरेडी हे जे एलिमेंट्स आहे हे डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डरमध्ये फाइंड आउट केलेले आहेत, बरोबर आहे. आणि आपल्याला अजून एक गोष्ट काय करायची आहे की वी हॅव टू डिस्प्ले द टॉप 5 स्कोर्स, बरोबर आहे ना. सो टॉप 5 स्कोर्स म्हणजे काय, तर 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, दीज आर दी टॉप 5 स्कोर्स, ठीक आहे ना. हे फाइंड आउट आपल्याला करण्यासाठी आपण हा बबल सॉर्ट हा आपण डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डरमध्ये हे केलेला आहे, ठीक आहे. आता याला जर असेंडिंग ऑर्डरमध्ये जर करायचं असतं आपल्याला, इफ वी नीड टू अरेंज दिस एलिमेंट इन असेंडिंग ऑर्डर, सो इन्स्टेड ऑफ दिस लेस दॅन जस्ट वी हॅव टू मेक अ मॉडिफिकेशन ॲज ग्रेटर दॅन, ऑलराईट. फर्स्ट एलिमेंट इज ग्रेटर दॅन द सेकंड एलिमेंट, इन दॅट केस वी नीड टू स्वॅप इट, राईट, in case of ascending order, but this is descending order, so only one change will be needed in order to arrange the element in ascending order, okay. I hope you understand this. So this will be the output after this bubble sort method, okay. So bubble sort we have applied and then we are showing that marks after sorting, okay. After sorting whatever will be there in the array that will be displayed, okay. Now here we are displaying the top 5 scores, okay. If length of array is greater than equal to 5, okay, then in that case we are writing here like this, top 5 scores will be this in the range 1 to 5, and one by one we are printing the elements. This will be a of 0, this will be a of 1, a of 2, a of 3 and a of, okay. So 5 scores will be displayed like this. Otherwise if length of array is not greater than or equal to 5, means we do not have 5 elements in our array, we have let us say 3 or 4 elements in our array, so in that case we cannot print the marks of 5 students, right. So in that case we will come to else part. So jitke kahi elements tumcha kade ahe te sage element apan ithe print karto ahe, barobar aahe. Suppose length of array is let us say 3, right. Length of array is not greater than equal to 5, let us say length of array is 3, so we will write the for loop as for I in the range 3, right. So 1, 2 and 3, those 3 elements only will be printed, 1, 2 and 3, so only 3 students top scores will be printed. But whereas if we have
the length of our array greater than or equal to 5, in that case we can print all the top 5 scores. Okay, so like this program will be executed. Okay, let me show you the output. I need to remove this first. So I'm again executing this Python sorting.py. Okay, so this will be printed on your screen. Number one, accept and display the FE marks. Number two, selection sort in ascending order. Number three, bubble sort in descending order and display top 5 scores. And number four for exit. So I'm starting with option 1. Okay, so now it is asking, enter the total number of students. Let us say 7. Enter the first year marks of 1, that is student 1. So I will write here, let us say 58. For second student, it is 59. Third, 44, 67. 72, 85, 60. Okay, so like this I have entered 7 elements here, and the array of FE marks is like this. So now this is the effect of calling the display function. Okay, whatever marks we have entered in the same order, it has printed it. Okay, so now accept marks and display marks, both the functions are executed here up to this. Okay, now let us sort this element by using selection sort. So I will press here 2 for selection sort. So see here, marks before sorting are this one. Okay, this message is printed and followed by the original marks display method. Okay, and marks after sorting, that is after applying the selection sort, the marks will be like this. So these are arranged in ascending order. Okay, next I will check for the third option, that is bubble sort in descending order. So see here, again marks before sorting are this one, marks after sorting will be this one. Okay, and top 5 scores will be 89 72 67 60 and 58. These are the top 5 scores. Although we have 7 elements, but that loop we had set up to 5 only, right? So only 5 elements will be printed. Okay, and 4 for exit.